This is another requested video from you. Requested me how to get checkbox values. After I showed you how to get those values from drop-down menus which are selected, today I will show you how you can get all checkbox values on your page and store them all in one array variable. Here I have created three input fields and these are of type checkbox. So these are three checkboxes. And as you know guys, in radio buttons and in checkboxes, these fields are groups and groups always have name. For example, these three checkboxes are in group cars. They all have the same name of car. If you would create like radio buttons, that would be the same. They would have their name, so that would be group name of that radio button group. I will show you now what I mean. Let's go to our page. I have here three checkboxes and these checkboxes are of group cars. And if you would want to create on your form or on your web page another checkboxes which are different, for example for fruit, then you would give other name fruit instead of cars and they would have different values, value BMW, Audi and Opel. They might have like banana, orange and so on and so forth. Once this is clear guys, and this is the main thing what you need to understand about radio buttons and checkboxes, that each radio buttons and checkboxes, even if there are more of them on your form, you can access them by these group names or radio button group name or checkbox name. So let's go into JavaScript. Let's create a new variable and I will call this variable cars, where I will store all values, and this variable will be array which will store all values which are in group name cars. And let's write a document dot get element by name. Okay, and as you understand now, we have of this group name cars. So let's grab this cars and let's put it here, cars. And now we are getting and storing all cars. To make sure that we are actually storing and this cars is now array of this group cars, we can check it by alerting out the number. And as you know, in JavaScript, we can use alert and cars.length. And how to get values of each I will show you as well in a second. So cars.length. So we will check how many elements are stored in this cars array. So let's save it. Let's go back to our page. Let's refresh page. And as you see here now guys, we are storing three elements of cars. As you will see now, I will create another checkbox just to show you. And I will give this checkbox a different name, fruit. And I will call this fruit apple. Okay, and value will be as well apple. And now let's save and you will see that it will give me still in cars, it will still me give me three values in not four now. As you see, it still gives me three. But if I would want to check how many of group fruit we have on the page, so instead of cars I would put here fruit. Okay, let's save it. Let's go back to page, refresh, and you see it gives me one. So this is the main thing what you need to understand about checkboxes and radio buttons, that they all are grouped by name and they are grouped into groups. Well, in cars you know that we have three values and these values are stored in cars and they are stored as arrays. So to get, for example, second value out, as you know, arrays count starts from 0, 1 and 2. This means that Audi would be number 1. So we go cars and instead of length, for example, you can loop this through, but I will not be writing for loop or any other loop. I will show you simply how you can get particular value and you can easily then write a loop whatever you want and then use it however you want in your scripts guys. And let's go with first, like I said, we will be getting out Audi, alerting out Audi, and after we put dot and value. As you know, everything in forms are get by value, dot value. So cars one dot value. So we're getting first element, first array elements value. This will be Audi. So let's go back to our page, refresh, and you see we outputted Audi. If you would want to get Opel out, that would be 2, as BMW in array is 0, 1 and Opel is 2. So let's put here 2 and we will alert Opel. Let's save it And now I will close this old one and refresh, and you see I'm getting Opel. If I would want to get this Apple value out, I can change this to cars to, sorry, fruit. Okay, and here I will give it a value of 0 because there is only one element, and first element is 0. Let's save it. Let's go back to our page. Let's refresh, and we get Apple out in this alert box. So yes guys, this is how you easily can access checkboxes and radio buttons on your pages or HTML pages with JavaScript. If you found this video useful, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel, and see you in my videos.